For Aussies struggling to find a home in the blood sport that is our current housing crisis, it's a kick in the guts. Wasted properties and blocks of land left vacant for months, even years. Now, there are moves to change all that by force, if necessary. It's the latest Hail Mary being thrown at the housing crisis.
Oh my goodness.
A tax on landowners designed to knock the supply shortage on the head.
I think it got him in the face.
From 2025, the vacant residential land tax, which currently applies to homes left empty for more than 6 months in Melbourne, will be expanded to the rest of the state. Owners slugged 1% of the property's value annually. Empty residential land left undeveloped for 5 years in Melbourne will also be taxed from 2026.
If you ever needed evidence that Victoria was broke, this is it.
I hope that I don't get any money out of these changes. I hope it amends behaviour.
Earlier this year, Tassie pulled a similar move, raising rates for unused residential land in an effort to combat land banking, a practice where developers hoard land and release it in dribs and drabs to maximise profit.
You don't build on it, you don't utilise it, you just hold on to the land because you know that you're going to get a capital gain in the future.
Across the country, vacant lots abound, with work yet to begin on more than 16,000 homes approved for construction in New South Wales, 10,000 in Victoria, and 100,000 in Queensland.
There are multiple issues which can cause a delay in development activity. Sometimes they relate to the behaviour of government and statutory authorities. And secondly, construction costs could be very excessive.
Developers and property owners say they've been blindsided.
We have very little detail about all the moving parts to this tax.
And policing the new tax could be difficult.
That tax is a voluntary tax. We do know that not one fine has been issued, and if they don't employ those resources to audit what properties are left vacant for long periods of time, then it has to rely on self-reporting. We need to ask ourselves whether the government is just doing a little bit of tinkering around the edges or whether they're actually doing something that is going to cause a significant difference.
So can we tax our way out of the housing crisis, or is this slap
in the face?
For landowners, a bridge too far.
That'll spin your cap right there.
So if you've got $1 million property sitting there, they're going to tax you $10,000. But I think if you've got the option to have $1 million property sitting there with no renters in it, I don't know if $10,000 is going to really change your life.
Yeah, right.
Enough to make a difference.
Yeah. And you have to be self-reporting as well. So do you have confidence that you're going to put your hand up and be like, yeah, guys, you got me, I should be paying tax on this land.
I don't think any Australian has ever said, hold on, where's my phone? I've got to report to the ATO. I owe more. I owe more money.
Yeah. But it's proof of concept, isn't it? Like, so theoretically, if this tax comes in... Mm. And the self-reporting there, the next step, 5 years, 10 years, whatever, is to say, all right, no more self-reporting, and you can't argue over that. So isn't this a way that it becomes established as a tax and then it works?
Well, so you think it's going to be an optional tax for 5 years and then become a compulsory tax after that?
Well, it's compulsory at the moment, Michael. I mean, we should be paying our taxes, but but the mechanism might change. But I think it's a really interesting idea because I've often wondered this. Vacant property is a real problem, in one way or another. But the only thing I wonder is once you create a loophole, there's ways through it. So, like, for example, if the property is vacant for 5 years, you get taxed on that, right? Mm-hmm. But if you've got development proposals in a council and it takes a long time or whatever, then
but
maybe...
But there always has
that.
To be exemptions, right?
Right, but once you create that exemption, then, I might change my plans now, and now there's another property to proposal.
Well, this tax got announced today and you're already finding loopholes in it. Dodgy builders on a current affair very soon.
I'm also establishing my accountancy practice. If anyone would like to...